It's difficult to know where to even begin with The Last of Us Part 2. The game is such a monumental production in terms of its scope, systems, interactivity, combat mechanics, level design, and so much more that talking about it feels a little overwhelming. I will say The Last of Us Part 2 is one of the most engaging titles I've ever played. It all starts with an audio-visual presentation that, to me, is pretty much unmatched. Yes, there are certainly games out there that trump it on a sheer technical level, but there's something about The Last of Us Part 2's art direction that completely grounds you into the world unlike any other game. The developers over at Naughty Dog set out with one mission when it comes to visuals, and that's to make everything you see look and feel believable. Almost everything in the world is lit in such a perfect manner that some areas hinged into creepy, uncanny territory. This sort of hyper-realism extends to the game's audio and physics systems, where things like a power cord or a rope behaving the way they genuinely would in real life just takes you by surprise, or the way glass shatters and breaks in tiny pieces. I rarely say this about any game, but The Last of Us Part 2's use of silence is such a welcome thing. The team at Naughty Dog understand when to implement that masterful soundtrack and when to let the sounds of the environments themselves do all the talking. From the light touch of film grain, superb material work, and the expert use of low-level lighting, there is a hyper-realism to everything that really just transports you into that world. Exploration feels rewarding with so many rooms and passageways opening up new areas of opportunity, each coming with their own manner of environmental storytelling, hidden upgrade, or a bonus weapon.
This might come in handy.
There were so many rooms and houses and alleyways to explore that I honestly started to feel a little overwhelmed in every new area, but in a good way. The way characters wince or express pain, anger, or fear in the game world. The way enemies, be they human or infected, react realistically when getting shot or blown to bits. There's just so much insane attention to detail that I can't remember how many times I just stood there in shock because I didn't expect those details to be there in a game. The combat has seen a sizable upgrade over its predecessor too. While the ability to jump or go prone aren't new in the third-person shooter space at all, they're new to The Last of Us, and both add entirely new dimensions to combat and encounter spaces. Sprinting and jumping from different spots or going prone to hide or reach different areas shakes up fights against both the infected and human AI. Every combat area is designed with these new mechanics in mind, offering a ton of different access points, crevices, rooms, alleyways, windows, and tall grass to use to your advantage to flank or separate enemies from each other.
We're not alone.
I'll see what's up.
The addition of dogs is another wrench thrown into the equation to force you out of your comfort zone and keep you on your toes at all times. Enemies like the Scars whistle to speak to one another and give commands and actions in the field, something that Naughty Dog actually researched. It's little aspects like these that all add up together to form an incredibly fun gameplay experience. Now, the topic of The Last of Us Part 2's story is definitely its biggest point of contention. There's arguably two camps. You either love it or you hate it. And I happen to personally fall into the former. The original game is among the top 5 best games I've ever enjoyed, and I was hesitant when I started hearing so much disdain after pre-release leaks started popping up everywhere. And luckily, I managed to avoid it all and experience the plot in full context. And honestly, I understood it. You know, it's hard to really express why without spoiling. But one thing I will say is that the world of The Last of Us isn't meant to be black and white. There really isn't a good or a bad guy here. Now, I love Joel. We all do. He's done bad things before. A lot of bad things. The same as almost everyone in that world, and why telling a story from two different perspectives adds so much to understanding that world. The narrative of The Last of Us Part 2, in my mind, isn't a story about revenge so much as it is rather about forgiveness and empathy. Now, when someone's lost just as much as you have in your life, you know, there comes a point where you ask yourself, well, how much more do you take? And the characters in The Last of Us Part 2 are broken and beaten down, but that's what makes them believable. I've always found flawed characters in entertainment to be far more interesting and endearing than squeaky clean one-note heroes. To make mistakes is to be human.
You do this, I'm not saving your ass again.
I really hope you make it.
There's absolutely nothing wrong with being dissatisfied and voicing constructive criticism, but going to extreme lengths to disparage creators takes on a new level of ugly, and I don't want to get into that. There's so much to love about The Last of Us Part 2 that I don't see it leaving my mind anytime soon. In fact, I'm already looking forward to that second replay once I have my mitts on a PS5. My best advice for anyone who has yet to play The Last of Us Part 2 is to just take a chance and experience it yourself. You might find playing the game yourself to make all the difference.